Now we are going to discuss a theorem that is called Ore's theorem, which tells when will be a graph a Hamiltonian. Will be Hamiltonian. So theorem is that it is Ore's theorem. For this, let G be a graph of order. Let G be a graph with order n and n greater or equal to 3. If degree of v greater or equal to n, where and it is nothing. I'm writing it again. If degree of u plus degree of v, it is denoted by delta. Now, what is the meaning of delta z? Delta z greater or equal to n, where delta G denotes the minimum degree. Minimum degree sum of two. Condition is again U and V are non-adjacent vertices. Two non-adjacent vertices of G. Okay, if this condition hold, then we say then G has a Hamiltonian circuit. Is it clear? Now we move for the proof of this theorem. I will write the hint of to prove the theorem. Okay. Here G is a, let G be a, here it is a simple graph. Condition is that it is a simple graph. Now, so suppose that statement is false. We start the proof here. First, we assume that suppose that the statement is false. Okay, because order is given here, n is given, for given any n, okay, for some n there exists is, it means that for some n there exists a graph, say H. Of order n. Condition is that such that delta g, it is delta g of h greater equal to n. But what? H is not Hamiltonian. But H is not Hamiltonian. Okay, suppose the statement is false. It means that for a given n, it is given n, or for some n, there exists a graph, say H, whose the condition is given is here, delta H greater equal to n, but H is not Hamiltonian. Okay. H is not Hamiltonian. Okay. It is not Hamiltonian. H is not Hamiltonian. Okay. So can we add one is in the last class I had discussed that if in a graph there are 2k odd vertices, then there exists a unicursal line. Okay, there exists a unicursal line, and we can add a line between these two odd vertices. And okay, same here, we add edge in G. If we add an edge in G, now add n is if possible between non adjacent vertices. Of H. Okay, we are saying that H is not Hamiltonian, but this graph, because delta H greater equal to means degree of U plus degree of V is equal to delta H, and it is greater equal to N, where U and V are non-adjacent vertices. So we can add, if it is possible, add as many as between the non-adjacent vertices of H. Then what will happen? Question, when adding the n is or many is between non-adjacent vertices of H, द रिजल्टिंग ग्राफ जी इज स्टिल नॉन हैमिल्टोनियन. ओके, दिस इंप्लाइज दैट H is still non Hamiltonian. Okay. H is still not Hamiltonian. Sorry. Where we assume that H is not Hamiltonian. Okay. And H is not non-Hamiltonian, then what will be the happen? I think I have some problem. G is a maximum non-Hamiltonian graph. We at statement is false. We have already assumed that statement is false. For if it statement is false, for some integer n there exists. Okay, and certainly it is not a complete graph, and H is not a but condition is here, delta H greater or equal to N. Now the condition is here, delta H greater or equal to N here. So we can conclude here, H is not a complete graph means how many A's in the complete graph? Number of A's in the complete graph?
The maximum number.
Yes, maximum number or maximum means how many A's in the complete graph? Kn has n n minus 1 by 2.
Yes.
Okay. there is no concept of maximum. There is a total number of A's in the complete graph will be n, n minus 1 by 2. Degree of each vertex?
Degree of V is?
N minus 1.
N minus 1. Okay. Now, see here. We suppose that the statement is false. Then for given some n, say we say that h is n. And which is greater or equal to n, but h is not Hamiltonian. Okay, adding some a's between non-adjacent vertices of h, because u and v are non-adjacent vertices. Okay, and it is not necessary, these are only two, u and v. There are may be one and maybe more. Okay, now adding the a's H is still non-Hamiltonian. Okay. Or H is not a complete graph. Complete graph means degree of graph will be here n plus 1. Okay. So what is the meaning of that? You can see, because in the complete graph, degree of u is equal to, and degree of v greater is also greater is equal to n minus 1. And if these are non-adjacent, and but in the complete graph they are adjacent. Okay, but condition I have taken that u and v are non-adjacent. Okay, still so condition is that if you add u plus v, it is greater or equal to 2n minus 1. Okay. But it is not possible. Means it is 2n minus 1. And I have taken that order of u only greater or equal to n. And I am, in this case, I am saying that order of means degree of u plus v greater or equal to n. Is it possible? Okay. No. Suppose now let we add again, we can let add an A's XY in G, then the graph will be here G plus XY, where X and Y are non-adjacent vertices. X and Y are non-adjacent vertices. Okay, then it means that X plus Y, if when we add X and Y by an A's, then the graph G plus XY will be a graph, new graph. Okay, and it is necessarily that G plus is a Hamiltonian. Okay, G plus X plus GY is a Hamiltonian. G plus H is a Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian. If it is Hamiltonian, then there exists a circuit. There exists a, I'm writing here again, there exists a yes, circuit. There exists a circuit gamma. Okay. There exists a circuit gamma with XYAs. Okay. And it means that if it is a circuit, then there will be a path. Okay, there will be a path. Okay, and that path, in the that path, that it contain X, Y, A's, yeah, or we can say just there is a path whose X and basically we can say because it is a circuit, the circuit may be like this way. Okay, and in this circuit, there are two X and Y vertices. These are non-adjacent vertices. Okay, when we add, okay, in the circuit, there are X, Y, and we can see that there is a path, and we can say that here, this one, this is a path. We can say this one is a first path, and also we can say this one, this is second path. Okay, it means that there is a path whose end vertices are X and Y. Okay, so condition is that, so here X, here it is a vertex, okay, and suppose V is any vertex, X and VI, this is the, this implies that belongs to EG. I have taken the graph G, okay. That graph under this. Vi belongs to G. Is X and Vi is belongs to this, and where I lie between n minus 1. Okay, then the A's Y Vi minus 1 does not belongs to EG set of A's. Okay, this condition, otherwise what will happen? Otherwise there is a another circuit, otherwise there exists a circuit gamma in G. This circuit is in G plus XY. Okay, this circuit is G plus XY. Okay, the path, there are endpoints X and Y. It means that for XY means these, if these A's belongs to this set, then these A's will not be belongs to this set. Okay, if otherwise, what will happen? There exists a circuit gamma 1, say, in G. Otherwise, there exists a circuit gamma 1 in G. So, Hamiltonian. G is हैमिल्टोनियन। ओके, जी इज हैमिल्टोनियन। ओके, ओके, सो इन दिस के आई थिंक समथिंग इज गोइंग टू मिक्स, समथिंग इज गोइंग टू बैड रिटर्न। ओके, सो आई थिंक यू विल नॉट, अकॉर्डिंग टू माई व्यू यू विल नॉट गेट गेट इट। ओके, सो टुमारो आई विल डिस्कस दिस प्रूफ। ओके, प्लीज लीव इट, ओनली रिमेंबर द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ दिस थ्योरम that GB in simple graph with order 3 n greater or equal to 3, and if the degree is like this one, then we can say that G has a Hamiltonian circuit. Okay, so tomorrow I will discuss the proof of this theorem. Okay, please leave it. Because I think there are some problems in this book proof. Some books are given in different ways of the proof of this book, proof of this theorem, and some books are the proof is given in different ways. Okay, so tomorrow I will discuss the proof of this theorem, Ore's theorem. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Because in the nursing day book, the proof is differently way. Okay, and there are others book, and in that book the proof is given in different way. Okay, then it means so tomorrow I will discuss this proof again. Okay, I was try to proof of I was try. To provide this proof according to my opinion. Okay, but I think here is some problem. Basically, these two theorems is based on the these results. Okay, that theorem is the here. In a complete graph with n vertices, theorem is that in a complete graph with order n, okay, with order n. There are n minus one A's, there are n minus 1/2 A's is, there are n minus 1, 2 is disjoint Hamiltonian circuit. This disjoint Hamiltonian circuit. Okay. If n is odd number and n greater or equal to 3. Okay, so the proof is also, I will provide the proof of this theorem is tomorrow again. Discuss the proof of this theorem tomorrow. And one more result is here. These are the results. I am writing here the result only, no need to prove. If G is a simple graph, okay, with order n, with order n, n greater or equal to 3, such that the degree of every vertex in G is at least n by 2, then G has a Hamiltonian circuit. Then G is a Hamiltonian. Yeah, just Hamiltonian means it has a Hamiltonian circuit. Okay, and one more result here. If G is a simple graph with order n greater or equal to 3 and is e greater or equal to 1 by 2 n square minus 3 n plus 6, then G has a Hamiltonian. Okay, G has a Hamiltonian circuit. Okay, so these are more two results. This one is okay. Actually, in the literature, there is no sufficient condition exist for a graph that means a general graph. In the literature, there is no any theorem provided. There is no sufficient condition for the existence of the Hamiltonian circuit in a graph. Okay, so it means that this is unsolved problem till yet. Are you getting my point? It is unsolved problem till date. For a graph has a Hamiltonian circuit. Okay. It is unsolved problem till now. Okay, now what is the application of Hamiltonian circuit? The first problem is closely related to the Hamiltonian circuit is TSP problem. What is the problem? TSP, traveling salesman problem. So, traveling salesman problem is based on the Hamiltonian graph. Okay, so now I will state what is the problem. The problem is that now traveling salesman problem. Okay. It is called TSP problem. Okay, so what is the problem? Problem is that a salesman is required to visit a number of cities, a number of cities number of cities what is the route he should take? Problem is that what is the route he should take if he has to start at any start suppose at his house his house city visit each city exactly once and again the return to house and then रिटर्न टू ट्रेवलिंग द
सर पीछे वाली स्लाइड दिखाइए.
Exactly once and then return to his return to home house or home traveling the minimum distance. Minimum distance. Okay. I think it is clear. Means it means. Suppose a salesman is required to visit some number of cities. Okay, any salesman. Okay, then what is the route he should take if he has to start at his house or home? Suppose, okay, his home city, visit each city exactly once and then return to his home or house. Traveling the minimum distance. Traveling the minimum distance. So, next, according to this one is the problem, and next point will be the formulation of this problem. Okay, it is a physical problem, and formulation means we can take vertices as city and the distance between the vertices we can take as the edge of the graph and the length or distance between the cities can be represented as weight of the edge. Okay, so according to this rule we can formulate our problem TSP problem into the graph theory problem, and after that I have the solution. So what will be the solution? So what is the meaning to find a solution? Actually the solution of this differential equation means we have to find a closed walk means just we have to find a Hamiltonian circuit. We have to find a Hamiltonian circuit, or we can say that we have to find a closed walk. Okay, closed walk that contains each vertices exactly once and the total weight of the walk is minimum. That is, we have to find a Hamiltonian circuit, with minimum weight. Okay, is it clear? Are you getting my point? टीएसपी प्रॉब्लम इज क्लियर?
यस सर।
ओके, नाउ वी मूव अनदर टॉपिक विच इज रिलेटेड टू द हैमिल्टोनियन सर्किट. ओके, इन दिस इन द कमिंग पॉइंट इन द कमिंग TSP problem is based on the Hamiltonian circuit. Okay, but it does not tells about the what is the shortest path between the any pair of vertices. Okay, just it means it is a just problem that is the postman and he want to start from his house. We have a weighted graph and we have to find, okay, we have to find a shortest path between any pair of vertices. Okay, so our coming point is our coming discussion is how to find the shortest path between any pair of vertices. Okay, between any pair of vertices. Is it clear? So it will be start basically to find the shortest path between two given vertices. We will use Dijkstra algorithm. Okay, we will use Dijkstra algorithm. Okay, so tomorrow we will discuss these two points. Means we will discuss that proof of the theorem and also we will discuss the how we will define the shortest distance and how to find the shortest distance between given vertices by the Dijkstra algorithm. Is it clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Everything is clear?
Just share kar dijiye, sir.
I will share. Okay, please. Ignore the proof of Ore theorem. Okay. This one is so I will clear frame and also I will this clear frame and clear frame and I think okay. Now I can share proof is. DST mathematics and it is here. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Have you click? Okay.